the evidence itself has not been revealed, U.S. intelligence is claiming to have proof of China manufacturing nuclear weapons, a blatant infraction of international treaties. China has made an unmitigated denial of the charges, restating the belief that diplomatic talks with China continue to crumble. U.S. military forces are mobilizing towards the anticipation of possible hostilities. China again denies any involvement in Kombin Nikoladze's... Oh my God. ...broadcast through the internet just minutes ago.
Cannot allow my nation to be subjected to the blatant international despotism of the United States or the cronyism of its allies. The world is not yours alone. And the soldiers you send into it are all equally guilty of American fascism. At 5:30 p.m. Greenwich Standard Time, the United States soldiers captured in a just war against their motherland will be executed. Their deaths broadcast for the world to watch.
Mouksovo meets Yangon, Myanmar, November 11th, 2004, 22:52 hours. Rescue the captured U.S. troops in a desperate act of defiance against the U.S. Nikoladze arranges the immediate live webcast executions of the captured U.S. soldiers. Vyacheslav Grinko will direct the soldiers' deaths. The executions must be prevented to preserve any hope of stabilizing political relations with the Chinese. That is, if the Chinese aren't involved in this, which they aren't. I mean, we know that at least they claim, diplomacy claims that, you know, Kong Feirong is acting on his own, but yeah, thus far, the Third Echelon does not know that, and this matter might just get even further complicated. Now, I actually had a lot of fun with this mission as well, and I don't understand logic as to why this is a mission based on stealth, despite the sheer amount of shootouts in this mission. But apparently, it has an alarm limit as well. Like 3 lives and you're done. So yeah, I just found it a little odd, but anyway, I digress. Without further ado, let's just go ahead and see how this went.
Fisher, we're getting close to war. If Nikoladze kills these men on live broadcast, we're sunk.
Are we worrying about the broadcast or the murders?
For now, the broadcast. It'll buy us time to stop the killings. Nikoladze is broadcasting from an antenna on the roof. First objective. You'll find the rest on your offset.
Well, that is sort of cold, but also quite rational, because, stop the broadcast, you can delay the executions, but then again, that's not exactly what the normal person would say, you know. But then again, he's Lambert because, you know, he can make tough decisions like this, tough, cold decisions. So, yeah, sometimes it's pretty counterintuitive. A lot of these things are, actually. I mean, at this point, what's intuitive is essentially, you know, whatever you've been taught. You just think of the... If I hadn't missed the first shot, it would have been like a smooth snipe for all three. And at this point, I believe I was searching for a meal on one of these people. I think it's it's with this guy. So basically, this mail is something that, you know, broke my heart the first time I read it, and pushed me towards you guys can go ahead and pause if you want to read it, but it sort of pushed me towards essentially playing things, essentially focusing on stealth rather. Because that guy had somebody waiting for him at home, and it wasn't the case that he was a bad guy. He is essentially following orders, and
General, this is Badri. The landmines are in place. Make sure nobody without the polarized thermal sensor enters the courtyard.
I mean, on one hand, there are people who are actually committing atrocities, but on the other hand, there are also those who have no clue about what's going on in the world. For example, there are actually videotapes of, you know, Nazis watching what exactly happened in these concentration camps, and they could not even bear to look at it. Some people were just, you know, hiding their faces in their hands. And these people aren't necessarily guilty just because they're on the wrong side. And it is sort of my belief that soldiers and their families are pretty much probably the first victims of the political conquest known as war. But anyway, let me know what you guys think of it. As it turns out, this mission actually has an alarm system. This guy tossed a grenade at me and I'm just too busy, you know, shooting him. I probably should have ran for it.
Watch the alarms.
Yeah. I can understand the point to alarms at this point in time, but I don't understand why, you know, you would require alarms when they are already suspecting American troops of having attacked the base. But there's an alarm requirement there as well. I mean, 4 alarms and the mission's over. Sam sort of makes a joke about it in Chaos Theory, and I'm guessing this is where he was throwing it back to. You know, this is where... this is what he was referring to back then. But yeah, at least there are no more people for us worry about, and there are no spotlights. Like, even if you get noticed by the spotlights, which are still somehow magically swinging, there's nobody to really notice us. Anyway, so yeah, that door is a very tricky one because there's a literal landmine right at the doorstep, and I am not sure. Maybe you can sort of get into the building through that door, but yeah, I'm not sure how you would achieve it though. Maybe you could shoot at the landmine.
What was that?
But that doesn't necessarily work. There's also a medkit among the trash here. I don't know who threw a perfectly fine medkit away. It's either that or maybe it's infected and Sam, you know, isn't gonna live very long after this. After he administers this. But in any case, we are moving on. The first time around that I tried making this jump, it took me around 15 to 20 attempts just to, you know, get up there. But right now with the first person mod, I mean, of course, I'm pretty sure that the practice factors into it as well, but with the first person mod, I could achieve it in just one go. So yeah, that was nice. That was a refreshing change of pace. I initially thought that maybe I could shoot people, you know, from these skylights, since this is a tactical shooter mod and this level is shootout heavy as it is. But yeah, turns out that is not the case. You can't exactly do that. I was supposed to jump up there.
Give them fuller eye lights.
And
we
I am.
Barely see their faces when they die.
And I'm really grateful that I'm really grateful that I actually fell onto the roof there and did not make a noise, because you only get one chance to make a noise and then you get detected. Like, they send people up to the roof to investigate. So yeah, you need to be careful with this section. You can just wait here if you want to be safe and let the lights go out before moving further. I do mess up in the end though. Like, in the end I've got no choice but to mess up, and not like I don't have any choice but to mess up, but I just do mess up. So this is the only time you can drop onto the roof.
Should we check it out?
It's probably another rat.
Yeah, exactly. And I think you should be able to climb along this rope overhead right here so that you can actually make your way to this chain link fence without getting detected. But anyhow, well, I decided to just, you know, go for it. I mean, there's only one way for you guys to come out anyway, so what are you gonna do? Anyway, so yeah, I decided to. I just checked the objective once again, and here we are.
What the hell just happened? The broadcast antenna's down. We've got no outgoing signal.
You're under attack. The Americans are here. They've taken out the broadcast antenna.
Get Nikoladze out of here. I want his helicopter airborne now. I want a squad of technicians with an armed escort on the roof and repairing that antenna. I want the Americans found and killed.
Yes, sir.
It's always funny to me how...
Sounds like you shook things up pretty well, but it's only going to buy us a few minutes. Find those soldiers, Fisher.
I thought the point was to not shake things up. Anyhow, it's always funny to me how these guys always, you know,
I've got a corpse here.
Believe that they're like a multiple number of American troops every time Fisher, you know, raids a place. Maybe they just can't, you know, imagine a solo covert operative being put into place like a Navy SEAL. Like something that Fisher is basically. If I'm right on my Splinter Cell lore, like if I'm not wrong about my Splinter Cell lore, then I think that Fisher has had Navy SEAL training, and I think he also used to be in the Special Forces, but I could be wrong about that because that was featured in Essentials, and Essentials is considered non-canon, so yeah. But yeah, he definitely used to be Navy SEAL, and I'm guessing that's where he got all his stealth infiltration training from. I guess most of these people just can't fathom a solo operative being deployed. But what's even more funny is that, you know, when they look at the after effects of all the enemies that have been slaughtered and... or rather, I should say, felt for a more dignified tone to the action. Of when they look at all the enemies felt and all the, you know, after effects of Sam's visitation, they assume it's like it's somewhere between 10 to 80 soldiers. Like, definitely not just one guy. Oh, and unfortunately, Nikoladze is already leaving. The guy we came here to nab. Actually, we didn't come here to nab him, we just wanted to stop the executions. Prevent them. But anyhow, Sam is just so effective at his job that people automatically assume that it must have been at least 10 soldiers, like 10 highly trained operatives, or maybe even 80 trained operatives, when it's just Sam, good old Sam. And I sometimes wonder if Sam's name is a wordplay on, you know, the name for US, like Uncle Sam. But who knows? Who knows? Uncle Sam's gonna come get you. So this is one of the problems with this mod, and it's that you can never really tell when you're, you know, stuck to the corner or... whether you're just inches off of it. Because right now I was pretty certain that I was sticking to the corner when I, you know, peeked out to take a shot at him. But apparently I was not. I was off the corner. Maybe it was because I equipped my pistol without, you know, peeking around it. So that could have been probably why he saw me. But at any rate, it's a little confusing at times with this mod. And just because I'm playing it.
This is Nikoladze. Kill the American soldiers. Take them to the studio and kill them. We'll release the footage whenever we can. Tell Feirong we are moving ahead. I'll retrieve the Ark.
And we already have news of the Ark, and questions will now slowly arise as to what exactly the Ark is. Anyhow,
this is Grinko. I want the American soldiers prepped and in studio. The executions are going forward as planned. Yes, sir.
What the hell?
Where are you keeping the American soldiers?
Grinko will kill me.
He's not as creative as I am. Where are they?
Ow! Oh!
Where?
The basement.
Where's Grinko?
He'll murder you. He'll kill you all.
Where do I find him?
He'll find you. Kill me!
That was Grinko. He wants us to escort the soldiers to the studio.
You copy that, Fisher? The executions are going forward.
I heard. We got any more diversions?
Your gun's full of them. Make sure that escort doesn't reach our troops.
Yeah, so another peculiar thing which about the scene is how there's an AK on the table, but there's 5.56 ammo right next to it. And thus far, I've only seen these people carrying, you know, these troops carrying AKs. So I don't really know why they need to carry 5.56 ammo with them, because, I mean, yeah, there are a few variants of the AK, especially like our native military, the Indian Army, used to use the INSAS rifle, which is essentially a modified AK. But which was chambered for the 5.56 by 39 round, a hybrid round. But it was still an AK round, not, you know, some a NATO round. So it always confuses me whenever I enter this room as to why there's a NATO round
kept near, this
is right beside the AK.
It's not our place to question. Let's go.
Somebody's coming.
And this grenade is apparently so effective that...
Hold your position.
It literally just bounces all over the place, except for, you know, staying exactly where you put it. And being the dumbass that I am, I toss the grenade down there and never really utilized smoke. I just, you know, shot them regardless. So why did I even toss a grenade in the first place? Anyway. And yet again, I was busy being lazy and hesitant. Otherwise, I could have just gotten the first shot off. And saved myself from getting shot. Or rather, Sam from getting shot. Anyway, Sam loves them being close. Now I'm curious as to how the guy in the other room got to that deduction, you know? Because yeah, it could have been a shadow, but I honestly don't know how shadows... make noise.
Man down. He's dead.
And it always puzzles me how I have to equip my thermals to see these people, but these people can see me just fine, especially in the event of a shootout. So there was a cut there because I was trying to sneak past this guy, but you know, since I was on the pipes, he could see me clearly, which is something which I found pretty annoying, because I mean, it should not be that easy for him to see me, but he could. I mean, this game wasn't that well designed, but yeah, if you want to save yourself from being shot by the turret, basically being mowed down by the turret because there's no escape from it, this is the only path you have. Climb above it. And sadly, I still have not found a way to bypass this section without at least taking the other guys out. So I guess we just stuck with this illusion. And if you can see something glowing on the table, that's a medkit. Which makes me question things as to... Okay, and understand that this, you know, turret is warm because there's some friction in it, there's some moving parts in it, even though it should not be warm. But why is the medkit on the table warm? Like, why is this warm? It should not be warm. Is there like a heating element inside it? Very strange indeed. Yet again, people will just see me out of nowhere. And this is a fine example of bullets clipping, because that guy could. I mean, we literally have an obstruction between, but that guy could shoot me through it while I could not. So yeah. And sometimes these people don't even care about their own soldiers. I mean, I was holding that guy hostage, like a body shield. I still got shot, but I was holding him as a body shield, and you know, it didn't even matter. His friends just shot him anyway, shot me through him, in fact. Huh. I mean, tiny little things like these, I think they greatly improve them in Pandora Tomorrow and Chaos Theory, because there's like an entire stage in Pandora Tomorrow where you need to use a Militant as body shield to extract with him. And like I was saying, I mean, this game just has Bulletproof Plus in the most random of places. Like, who in the right mind installs ballistic glass inside of an abattoir? I mean, this is literally a slaughterhouse. Why is there ballistic glass here? I mean, did the Georgians make some improvements to the place? Did they like redecorate or something? I don't know what's going on. I mean, I'm genuinely curious at this point. At any rate. But then again, I mean, even as far as this mission is concerned, in Hold the Cell, you need to grab a general. And when you do grab the general, the other troops don't shoot at you. So yeah, I guess even this game has that refinement where they won't shoot at their own comrades. Well, comrades is the wrong word for it. For a general isn't a comrade, he's your superior. So yeah, I mean, they won't shoot at important people. Just the pipsqueaks. I'm just waiting for the guy from the other end to walk in so that I can shoot him dead. But yeah, he's taking his own sweet time, and we can just wait in the shadow as well.
Movement.
So right here I use a trick which I saw Center Strain 01 using. You shoot the light out so that the turret starts firing at it. I don't know how that works. Maybe the bright flash of the bulb gives you like the momentary bright flash of the bulb sort of pulls the aim of the turret towards it, because it's like a really high temperature thing. And yeah, but we've got tons of ammo here that we can utilize, like nearly endless ammo. So yeah, that's pretty useful. We're full up on everything. So, time for us to go, I guess. Now, if you recall, the guy outside was called David Sakandlitsa. This guy has the same name. This guy has an email to David Sakandlitsa, and I have got no clue why. Whether they're sharing emails or whether one of them is David, but at any rate, I have officially killed someone that has somebody waiting for them at home. And I don't know about you, but that sort of makes me a little uneasy, you know. Then again, I mean, on the field of battle, you do not think of things like or things of this nature, but on the flip side, they are also humans who are fighting to defend what they believe is right, and at times just following orders. So, I mean, can you really find them at fault for that, for doing just that? I tossed a flare there to lure these guys in. Okay, first off, I don't know whether how they can just see me in the shadows every time there's a confrontation, but I tossed the flare there to lure these guys in. That does not work. The turrets start glitching out, but I actually tried, you know, walking past these turrets. They're fine, they just don't want to shoot their own comrades. They start shooting at me. And yeah, I mean, of all the most inconvenient bugs that I could have found, this section and the one that follows this are pretty inconvenient. I take these lights out, I don't know why I'm doing that, maybe to distract the turret, but it does not work. It's pretty difficult to, you know, distract this one, and I'm just gonna make a break for it. And I almost die as a result. Could have picked this chemical flare up, but I decided not to. Just decided to top up on my health.
Oh, yeah.
And just shoot to kill some people like it's Rainbow Six, the people coming around the corner. I sometimes feel a little bad for doing this because...
I'm a soldier, not a sadist.
Because these guys aren't even, you know, like, preparing for combat. And I don't know how they saw it or who saw it, but it must have been one of the corpses from the previous rooms that I forgot to hide. Anyway.
Hand down. He's
dead. That's just how this game works, but it sort of does not make sense to me.
That's our limit. One more alarm and I'm aborting the mission.
Yeah, it just does not make sense to me how they have alarms at this point of the game where everybody already knows that there are intruders in the facility. Yeah, I mean, it would have made sense to me if the point was to keep that secret, keep the infiltration secret, but they already know that people are here, that there are enemy troops here to take care of the dead bodies. Not the dead bodies, the people kept ready for execution, the hostages being held, and I mean, if they already know that we're here, why even keep bother with the alarms? I mean, what point do the alarms serve at this stage? Especially when there's going to be like a full-blown shootout right afterwards. Either way, I decided to place a few more traps here and there. I was not thinking through when I placed that wall mine in the center, because that is exactly the path that I'm going to have to take to, you know, go to my usual hiding spot. But oh well. We can talk to these guys. It's not compulsory.
I want
to
go home.
It serves no purpose.
You've come to save us. Where are the others?
It's just me.
Oh crap.
I don't think we can help you. We're too weak to fight.
We haven't eaten in 2 days. I'm not sure I can walk.
Don't worry. Sam's gonna help you out. So yeah, I died to this turret or the wall mine like a few. I've died to these things a few times over just because I, you know, did not exactly think all of this through. But yeah, I finally decided to go with the flow, take things slow. Because as long as there are shadows, I can use it to my advantage. I was trying to attach another wall mine here, but the game just wouldn't have it. And I have one wall mine left to spare as a result. I'm trying to get a good screenshot right here, so yeah.
You are American.
You're Chinese.
Grimfangs, the PRC ambassador to Myanmar. I must speak with a representative of your government.
They hear everything I do. Shoot.
Kong Feirong does not represent the will of China. He is a splinter faction of the Chinese army, all of them fanatics and fools.
What does he want?
First, Taiwan, with others to follow. Gifts to the PRC he thinks they will not be able to refuse.
How is Nikoladze involved?
Trade. Feirong provides transport and munitions in exchange for weapons-grade nuclear waste.
Does China know?
No. And unless they are issued proof of Feirong's activities, I fear the certainty of war.
What's the proof?
On the computer in his office. My office. He has overridden and reset the lock.
I force him to open his computer and forward the contents to the PRC. And our countries don't go to war.
Such is my hope.
So, I mean, that's statement right there.
The Americans are taking the business. I want all available men armed to convert on the business.
So that statement right there sort of ties in with the story from nuclear power plant, because what they saw in nuclear power plant was nuclear waste being shipped out, and turns out that essentially Nikoladze was trading that with, you know, trading the nuclear waste with this Chinese general, the PLA general.
Colonel Bagrat, report! Colonel Bagrat! I'm going down there. Grinko, you're coming with me.
Yeah.
Bishop, kill Grinko.
Okay.
Men are mercenaries. Their only cause is money and intimidation.
And that's Nosenko dead there. But anyway, yeah, Nikoladze was exchanging nuclear waste for arms and ammunition from the Chinese. So yeah, that's why the nuclear waste was being exported from the nuclear power plant. And again, they neglected to fill in that little detail. And that's Grinko. I mean, they could just run out and kill him. No need to, you know, kill him like this.
Grinko is dead.
And that's it for this mission.
Fisher, Echelon just picked out an intercept. Feirong knows that Grinko's dead and Nikoladze is gone.
That's not good.
Get back to
that
the
was
embassy.
A quick message.
He's trying to destroy the evidence that could keep us out of a war.
Right.
Anyway, let's head over into the debriefing then. Mouke Sobo meets Yangon, Myanmar, November 11th, 2004, 23:57 hours. The rescue of the US troops and Chinese dignitaries has momentarily stabilized faltering US-Chinese relations. The Chinese dignitaries claim that Feirong represents only a splinter faction of the PLA, operating without the knowledge of Greater China. Proof that Feirong has gone renegade could prevent an impending war. So, yeah, that's basically what we need. However, here's the thing. Why do we need to get the proof? I mean, the Chinese dignitaries, the Chinese, what do you call them, the Chinese ambassadors are telling you that Feirong is rogue, meaning that China should, you know, reflect that statement. So I don't really think we needed this proof necessarily, because I think even China's statement would be to disavow Feirong themselves once this comes to light, you know, the proof of their affiliation comes to light, just so that they could avoid a war, an unnecessary war at that. But anyway, I mean, that's just the way that this has been written. So that's that for this mission. Fisher does not get a break, even though I do. But, I played clean attack without a break. Fisher got a huge break after that. So anyway, I will see you guys in the next video, which would be Chinese Embassy Part 2, obtaining proof that Feirong is acting alone. And until then, take care. Farewell, fellow things.